okay, shit, where do I start? It's almost 11 o'clock at night. I was filming all day. I did a ton of things, right? I got up and I practiced early this morning. And this is how most days start out. I worked all day mainly on the tour. I went through booking hotels and car rentals and flights, and I was talking about that, and the vlog was kind of going to be loosely based around what it takes behind the scenes to book a tour. And now, as of today, I have all the flights dialed in. I'm going from LA to Cleveland. Then the drive is going to be from Cleveland to Syracuse. Then I'm going flying from Syracuse to Boston super early. That's like a 6:05 a.m. flight. That's going to be a little brutal, but it did save me a 5-hour drive and extra rental car costs and gas. And it ended up working out much better to fly, even though it's going to be a brutal flight. But it is also, bonus point, is going to get me in at like 9:30 in the morning, rather than having to drive from Syracuse to Boston, which is close to a 5-hour drive, drop the car at the airport, and then get back into the city to Berkeley, where my clinic is at 1 o'clock. Then I'm gonna fly from Boston to New York, and then finally, after all the stuff in New York, I'm gonna fly home, Newark to LAX, where I have a gig with Bob Reynolds the same day that I arrive. So flights are all dialed in, rental car is booked. Some of the things I look for when I'm booking hotels, and I have one up here I'm gonna show you. I think this is where I'm gonna stay. Comfort Suites, Youngstown North. Big thing here is that it's free full breakfast, free Wi-Fi, and free parking. Now, there are hotels that will charge you $40, $50 a night for parking. The breakfast will be $25, and the Wi-Fi could be $15, $20, $30 a night. So when you see a hotel that's not only reasonably priced, this one's like $79 a night. That's a really good price. And it has those other things, plus I think a gym and a heated indoor pool, so I can actually get some exercise. That's a big win. I'm always looking for those things when I'm booking hotels. Then, after being super domesticated, I got out, I got to the gym. Okay, advantage of getting it done late. It's raining outside, it's dark, it's a little later than I normally work out, and I get the gym all to myself. Kind of nice. I managed to get in the swimming pool and the hot tub for a little bit of recovery in my legs in the rain at night. That was kind of cool. Perfect way to end a workout. Just did a bunch of laps in there, and now time to jump in here, which is kind of strange thing to do in LA at night in the rain. Outdoors, in the rain, in the hot tub. But it really works wonders for the legs. Great recovery after a big workout. And I'm still in time to get to IKEA, which is awesome. The day is going good so far. And then I went to North America's newest and biggest IKEA to look for some more shelves to expand my pedal library. All right, I'm done with the gym and the pool and the hot tub and everything. Feel great. It is pouring with rain. Now it's time for some IKEA. All right, here we go. It is pouring with rain. Parking lot is full. People are insane. I thought the rain would keep people at home. No, everyone came to IKEA. It's all the way over there. I don't have much of a jacket. This is it. Little Nike hoodie. Brain of Britain here. Oh my God. But here we go. Okay, all of that was meant to take 10 minutes. It was going to be a nice movie. There was, you know, a soundtrack, all kinds of stuff going on there. That was going to be today's vlog. Then I got home, I started cooking dinner, and I was binging on voice auditions, The Voice. TV show, I think it started in North America, maybe, I don't know where it started, but I first watched it here in the States. And there are so many of these videos on YouTube that are like the best of the blind auditions, the best of this, the best of that, the most emotional, the most mind-blowing, the judges turn four chairs in the first 5 seconds, so many videos. I was watching a ton of those while I was cooking and eating dinner, and it struck me. We're on day 73 today. And I have talked about this on VBL, the importance of this. I have. And I've made probably a dozen videos about it. But I've never made anything that's kind of free and open to the public and this specific about what I consider the most important and the most fundamental element of music to be. I think this might be the most important lesson I could possibly teach you when it comes to learning music, when it comes to being an instrumentalist, when it comes to being a soloist, when it comes to being a composer, when it comes to finding melodies, when it comes to connecting with an audience. It's the most important thing to me, and it has served me in my career more than anything else, really more than anything else, and that is singers. Singers are just the most important thing to me, and when it comes to transcription, when it comes to performance, when it comes to emotion, to feeling, to the subtleties and the nuances of phrasing and articulation, it all comes from singers. And for me, the kind of lineage, or not the lineage, the kinds of singers that I've checked out range from incredible gospel singers. To some of the biggest pop icons of all time that I grew up with listening to on the radio. To incredible singers in the jazz world, be that from, you know, 60 years ago. And a thousand violins begin to play. Or be that from like the 70s and 80s and my childhood. And of course, there are so many other things on top of that, in between that, interwoven from, you know, the Bulgarian women's choir to folk musicians from the Republic of Ireland to traditional singers from the extremities of Scandinavia. And we don't even get me started on Africa, because every country in Africa has its own tradition and own deeply rooted musical connection with the world based in voice and percussion. So yes, as much as I'm saying the voice may be the most important thing I could ever teach you or tell you about or expose you to, of course, percussion at the same time, I think those two kind of go so well together and are so fundamentally important to everything we do. Now, I was watching so many videos. It took me about 40 minutes to cook. I took a leisurely glass of wine and ate my dinner and took another 20 minutes. So I was watching YouTube for about an hour and following on recommended videos, related videos, and I heard so many things. I could make 1,000 examples of songs right now from every single genre and time period that we know about in the history of music. I'm gonna make way more vlogs about this and get specific about certain genres and specific things that I checked out. There was this one girl on the American edition of The Voice, and I believe that out of the four judges, only one judge, and I think that was Pharrell Williams, only one judge could make up their mind, could choose this guy. Everyone else's teams were full, so they couldn't press their button even if they wanted to. And judging by this video and their response to it and the fact that they all stood up in their chairs and turned around to watch the performance, they all wanted to press their button. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm not a huge fan of the TV vocal competition format. I think it might possibly be the kiss of death in terms of someone's career. I, off the top of my head, I can only think of Kelly Clarkson right now as a winner. I think she won the first season of American Idol. I can only think of her as somebody who went on to actually have a career. I know there are a couple of others, but in the grand scheme of things and how many seasons these shows have, the winners don't tend to go on and have these amazing careers. So I'm not the biggest fan of it. That's besides the point. I hope we can get past that. It was just the fact that, and you know what? Screw that. I am a massive fan of it because it gave me this performance today. It gave me this inspiration to completely change my mind. When right now I should be editing and uploading this to you, but I'm starting again from scratch. So you know what? A TV vocal competition did give me the inspiration to completely change my mind about what today's vlog was going to be. And it inspired me to remember and to rework and to open up this whole chapter of my life and of my learning process that I hadn't forgotten about. It's always been there and it's always been a massive foundation for me, but it inspired me to open up about it and talk about it and share that with you. So forget what I just said about not being into these shows. If that show wasn't there, perhaps that wouldn't have happened today. So for that, I am very grateful. You can always find something good, even in something that perhaps you don't like or don't agree with. So that's a great little bonus that came through today. But the song she was singing was Ed Sheeran's Photograph. I think she was doing a whole step up from the original key. I think the original key. I think the original key is E. She's singing it in F sharp. Okay, I'm switching audio sources now because it's late. I can't play that loud in my apartment, so I'm going straight into an external recording device so you guys will actually be able to hear the bass rather than it being somewhere in the background quiet and like just camera mic sound. So this girl is playing the song in F sharp. Put the sequence, the chord sequence in the looper. So, okay, so that's a very rough version of the chord sequences. It is, of course, Pachelbel's Canon in D. You've all seen that Pachelbel's Canon in D. I hope the comedy routine that a thousand songs are written based on this chord sequence doesn't matter. That's what it is. It's a very rough version of it. And here's the importance of what I'm trying to get to, I think, and what I've learned from singers. There's a lot of repetition in a chorus, for instance. So the chorus is something like, oh no, see, I got it wrong already. That's loosely the chorus of Ed Sheeran's Photograph, but it's repetition. How many times was the third used there? The whole melody is based around the third. It keeps coming back in and out, in and out, in and out, embellished here and there, but it's basically based around the third. We can take this so many places and transfer this to so many other situations, this basic concept of repetition. And again, that's the most important thing to me that I got out of singers and listening to singers. We can get to inflections and to phrasing and to time and sound of singers and how important that is. I'll make other vlogs, I promise. I will make other vlogs and really break this whole thing down. But again, it's late. I changed my mind about today's vlog at the last minute, and I wanted to get this idea out while I was inspired to get it out and while it was fresh in my head. And I think the first step of that, the first thing I really came to grips with and started to realize was the amount of repetition in a great chorus of a song. Now, I wish I had the time and had done days, weeks, months of research to give you 10 examples of repetition in the chorus of a song right now, but for now, that can be your homework. That can be for you to go check out and go listen to songs and recognize that and see, wow, okay, so Lady Gaga or Michael Jackson or Justin Bieber or anyone who's connecting with a massive audience, Bob Dylan, what about Joni Mitchell, what about Joan Baez, what about George Benson, what about Sarah Vaughan, what about Ella Fitzgerald? There are so many singers to choose from. We could go... you know, Donny Hathaway, Stevie Wonder. There's so many people you could go out and listen to right now and start to recognize repetition in a chorus. And of course, the chorus comes back again. So even if the first iteration of the chorus wasn't based around one single note, kind of like the Ed Sheeran thing is there, it repeats itself again later on in the song. So there's repetition there. Even if it's not super close towards one or two notes the first time around, it comes around again. And it will probably be looped again at the end of the song. So this is form as well as melody we're talking about, which is also super important. You've heard me talk about that before. Knowing the form of a song is just unbelievably important. And when you're composing as well as playing, I think that's super important. So to grab that idea and to take that into our improvisation or into our creation of bass lines. I mean, how repetitive
do we want to be as a bass player creating bass lines? I mean, that's a super important element of being a bass player, I think. People get fired for being too busy, for being too complex in the low end, because we don't need it. We need repetition, we need foundation. So there's no reason that can't apply to the entire spectrum, all the way from being a bass player right up until to being a melodist or a soloist or a lead instrument, you know, whether that's the bass. It doesn't matter which instrument you're playing. It really doesn't matter where you're coming from, what instrument, what genre, what style. I think the vocalist and the singer is the most important thing you can possibly listen to. Now, you hear me talk about listening all the time. How easy is it to put on the radio? This is subjective, of course, because you might not like what's in the top 10 at the moment on the charts. You might not be a Drake fan or a Chris Brown fan or a Justin Bieber fan or a Rihanna fan or any of those people. Whether you're a fan of their music or their aesthetic or their style even, or the sound of their voice, try and become, if not a fan, try and become curious about what it is, what the components are in their songs that put them in the top 10, okay? It's not just perhaps a seedy love life or a drug problem or this rock and roll image or social media. It's not just those things that make those songs connect with people. It's not just the behind the scenes thing and the image of the artist that make those songs connect. There's a reason that Justin Bieber, you know, Where Are You Now, you know, or whatever that melody is, you know, the Skrillex, Justin Bieber, Diplo track. I'm a massive fan of that song. I have used that particular motif dozens and dozens of times to improvise with. I've jammed along with that record. Now, whether you're a fan of Justin Bieber or Skrillex or Diplo or even that style of music or the top 10 of the Hot 100 pop charts in the US, maybe you want to be a little curious about the context and about the concept, maybe that's a better word, about the concept, the compositional concept of what they're doing and the repetition that's in there. And yes, the phrasing and the time and the sound, all those other components that make up the music. To get back to this girl on the voice that really like blew me away, I've of course linked the video with the starting point. You can, I'll tell you exactly where in the link below this video to where you have to go to get to the beginning of that performance. I hope you dig it as much as I did. I thought it was a really heartfelt and emotional performance, and there were so many things about the way she was singing that song. She wasn't copying Ed Sheeran exactly. She was doing her own thing, which is huge. I mean, imagine that for a concert and how important that is, to take somebody else's words, you know, somebody else's words that mean something to them, that were a story they were telling, and then to sing them yourself, but to be able to have your own unique thing with that. Taking a story that really isn't yours to sing it and being able to have a unique thing with it and being able to connect with an audience member, me being the audience member today watching this video on YouTube. That's pretty powerful stuff as far as I'm concerned. That's something I strive for every time I pick up my instrument. Now, I do not take other people's music that often and try and rework it and perform it to tell my own story with it. I'm generally playing my own music, but I do on occasion cover tunes and do reharmonizations of popular songs, and that's something I strive for all the time, is to be original with it, and that's something I get from singers. Hugely, hugely important element and aspect of my practice routine and of my transcription and assimilation of vocabulary when it comes to music. So let's take this loop. Let's make some musical examples of this repetition thing. The melody itself is already repetitive, which is just an awesome example, which is, what is it? Basing my first improvisation around the third as well. So there's two different ideas loosely based around the third already. just kind of, really just kind of going in the same vein as the melody in terms of the repetition. I'm not following the shape necessarily, but I am following the repetition. And the more you think about that, and the more you're aware of it, not so much that you think about it, the more you're aware of it when you listen to that kind of music, and the more you assimilate that when you transcribe and when your influences start coming from singers. It doesn't have to be Ed Sheeran and Photograph. It doesn't have to be from a YouTube video of the TV show The Voice. Let's just put that out there. It can be from anything. It can be from an Ella Fitzgerald song. It can be from a Joni Mitchell. It doesn't matter where it's from. That's the point I'm trying to make. There is going to be repetition there when it comes to singers. There is going to be this amazing ability to bend the note and to have all this phrasing and articulation that we don't necessarily think of from a technical standpoint. You know, for me, for instance, as a bass player with a fretted stringed instrument, I guess that goes for guitar players and for all instruments, I'm sure we don't initially think like a singer from a technical standpoint right away, because we do these kind of mechanical things for our instrument to practice, and those don't often include those in-between articulation things that you get from a singer. So there are so many things. Like I said, I'm going to make so many videos about this stuff in the future, and research and hone in on specific details. But I just wanted to get this in your head, get this in your mind, get this as a part of your thought process when you go about your practice routine and when you go about listening to music. And I can't speak highly enough to the importance of singers in our lives, you know. Thank you for bearing with me with the last minute change of plans here and kind of ditching the day's filming and going off on this tangent about singers. I hope it's been useful. I hope it's been insightful. And if you weren't thinking about it before, I hope you are now. I'm going to play out of this video with a little bit more of that repetition concept, just like the melody of Ed Sheeran's Photograph that this beautiful singer was covering. That's the thing that inspired me to do today's vlog. So it seems fitting that I end with that. Vlog is done. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Thank you.